Hello everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to create a student class to get student details such as name, roll number and marks in Java. So let's get started. So currently I'm having here a sample class and just a public static void main function. So just a standard stuff over here. So let's go and create our student class. So just go over here and type class student. Okay, so this name can be anything. So I'm naming it student because we are just going to get the details of the student. So first thing, what are the details that we are going to like enter here? So here we are going to have name, roll number and marks. So it's going to be string, okay, string name int roll number and int marks. Okay, so these are the three variables or three values that you are going to get for each student. So first let's have a constructor. The use of constructor is to just initialize values from the object to these variables. Okay, so constructor will be having the same name as of the class. So it's going to be student. And here we are having three variables. Okay, so we will be having three arguments over here. So let first argument will be string name. Okay, so here it will be string. I'll put n for name. And second is going to be int roll number. So int r. And third argument is int marks. So I will put int m. So this can be anything. You can name this whatever you want. And if you just go over here, and here we will just assign the values to this variables. Okay, so here it will be this dot, and here you need to be careful. Here you can't specify n or something random. Here it's to be this dot, this particular name, variable name. Okay, so it's going to be this dot name equal to n, and here it will be this dot roll number equal to r, this dot marks equal to m. So this is the use of constructor, which is just used to assign the values from objects to our variables of the class. So once you have done assigning all the values, you can just put it inside this. Okay. So once you have done with the constructor, next thing is we need a method or a function to display all those values for each object created, for each student basically. So for that, we will be having a function to display. So it's going to be public void display. Okay, so here it's just not going to have any arguments over here because we're just going to print the in the output form. Okay, so for that we'll be having just three print statements, one to print for each variable. Okay, so it's going to be system dot out dot println new line. So I'll be having the first thing as name. So I'll just go here and put a plus and I'll put this dot name. I need to be careful with this. It's only this name corresponds to this name. You can't change it. You can't like assign n or random things like that. So I will just copy this now and paste it twice. So instead of name, I will be putting here roll number and it's going to be this dot r number. So here it's going to be marks and here it's going to be this dot marks. So that's it, we are done with our print function, okay, display function. And next thing is, that's it, we are now just going to create an object of the class student and we're just going to call this method, okay. So for creating an object, it's going to be the class name. So it's going to be student, okay, and let my first object be s1, okay, s1 equal to new student, okay, and here we'll be passing three arguments. So this arguments count passed over here will be equal to the number of arguments that we are having over in our constructor. Okay, so we are having three over here. First is of string and the rest are of type integer. So first name, I'll just pass it as, let's say, John, and name I will put, next is the roll number, I'll put 1, and I'll put marks as 100. And once you're done creating the object, we're just going to access our function display with the help of this particular object. Okay, so it's going to be s1 dot display the class name, that's it. So as you can see, we aren't passing here any argument. So I'm just saving it now. So this is the code, so let me just run it now. So it's Java C. So I'm not getting any errors over here. So let me just run it. So as you can see here, I'm getting John roll number 1, marks as 100. So this is my object. So let me just briefly explain to you how this program flows, okay, how the work flows in this program. So first, we are just calling this constructor, okay, and we are just assigning to this object. So what it does is that this constructor gets called, and all the values are assigned, okay, by using these three lines to this particular object S1. So S1 has all these things. This is like a container of these three values: this name, roll number, and mark. And in like a class, we can access the function only with the help of our object. So S1 is our object, and with the help of S1, we are accessing the method or a function present inside the class. So this display class, this display function is present inside this student class. So we are just calling it, and here this name, roll number, and marks are getting printed. Okay, so this gets printed in this. The reason is because we are using S1.display to do that. And let's suppose say that I'll be just copying the same code, pasting it here. I'll put S2. I'll be putting new student. I'll be putting this, say, as Ravi is of roll number 2, and we put marks will be as 1000 as well. So I'll put S2.student. Okay, save it, and I'll just run it now. And this time, as you can see, we are getting name Ravi, roll number 200. The reason is because this data we are calling S2.display. And that's why we are getting this particular object's data. So these are the data of this particular object, and that is being displayed with the help of this function. So I hope you would have understand this. And now here is a problem. Okay, so let's suppose say that we are having like hundreds of students. Okay, and we need to repeat this particular thing. We need to create S1, S2, like that, S3, S4 till S100. So which is like highly repetitive code. Okay, so we can just minimize this work by creating a for loop. We can create objects with the help of a for loop itself and having them stored in an array list. Okay, so let me also show you how that works. Just remove this. First, let me declare a list. Okay, and this list is used to store our objects of the class student. Okay, so it's going to be like this. So it's going to be list of data type. So here our data type is going to be of type student. Okay, so if you're just doing normal numbers, it's going to be of int over here, but we are going to have objects of the class student itself. So it's going to be list student, our list name. So it will be list, yes, it's going to be the name of our student list, equal to new array list. Okay, so this should be like this way, capital A and capital L, array list and student, and just this bracket. And another important thing is that you need to import the header file, okay, using list. So it's going to be import java dot util, okay, dot asterisk. So this means that we're importing all the packages that are present inside this util class. Okay, so now we are done, and this is the syntax over here. What we are going to do is we're just going to push the object that consists of this name, roll number, and marks into this list of objects. Okay, so first let me have three arrays. Okay, let's have three arrays. One array to store name, roll number, and marks. So this is going to be like this. So it's going to be string. Let my name array be NA, okay, string NA equal to, let us say it has A, B, and C be the names present inside it, okay. Let me have also a roll number and a marks, which is of type integer. So it's going to be int RN equal to, let me have just 1, 2, 3, and int ma equal to, so this one is going to be the marks, so we put 80, 90, and 100. Okay, so I'm storing this in an array format just to minimize the code. Okay, instead of just hard coding for each object, I will be extracting the data from this array. So these are just the names, you can keep like whatever may be your choice. Okay, so now let's go and create our for loop. So it's going to be for int I equal to 0, I less than 3, I plus plus. And the reason why I am putting I less than 3 is because I am having only 3 values here. Okay, 3 values in my list. So it's going to be 0, 1, 2, and 3 values there. So when it comes to 3, it's going to break the condition. So the reason is that I am having 3 values. So if I am having here 5 or 10 values over here, you can just put 10, the number here itself. Okay, so now what we are going to do is we are just going to create an object. Okay, so it's going to be student. S1 be our object. So let us have S. Okay, so student S will be our object. S equal to new student, and here is the twist. Okay, so instead of passing the value, so what we did earlier, so we did like this, student S1 equal to new student. So we will pass the name, say Ravi, and we pass the mark, roll number and the mark like this, okay? So same thing we are going to do here. But our name is present in this array. Our roll number is also present inside this array. Our marks is also present inside this array. So what we'll be doing here is that instead of just hard coding the name, we will pass the array index as we are having the I value to iterate throughout this array each time, okay? So here I will put student na of I comma rn of I comma ma of I, okay? And after this, this object will be having this particular values. Let's say our I value is 0, okay? Our I value 0 means these three values, a 180 will be present inside it, and this will be stored in yes. And next line, what I will do is just go here, I will put list, which is this list, object list, list dot add yes, okay? So yes is nothing but this object, okay, student object over here. So let me just explain it to you like clearly. So what happens is that, so student is there, this for loop is there, I'm creating just an object over here. So during the first iteration, okay, our I value will be 0. So our I will be equal to 0, and what happens is that these three values, a, 1 and 80 will be stored inside this yes. And inside our main list, okay, this will be the, it's like list of 0. So list of 0 will be corresponding to a, 1 and 80. And during the next iteration, our I value will be 1. So 1 is nothing but b, 2 and 90. So this value will be stored in yes. And again, it will be added over here. So it will be added as list of 1. So list of 1 value will be b, 2 and 90. And same thing, when I value becomes 2, we will be adding c, 3 and 100 inside it. So list of 2 will be added over here. So it will be c, 3 and 100. So I hope this I made you clear, okay, how this works. And now once you're done adding all our values, we need to have access to that, right? So for that case, we will be using the get, okay, get function. So it's going to be list dot get and the index value. So let's suppose say that I want access this object that has b, 2 and 90 as values. So this is actually present in 2, 1, okay? It's actually present in list of 1. So this, but the problem with this is that you can't directly access by using index, okay? So that's why we are using this get. So list of 1 consists of b, 2 and 90. So here I will just put 1 and I will call the function display. So I'll just call the function display to display the values present inside. So same thing, we just use this. After doing this, we did s1.display, okay? So this is what we used, and instead of doing that, we are just having this present inside this list and we're accessing the index and we're just calling the function, okay? So I hope I made sense there. So let me just run it now. So I'm not getting any error. So as you can see here, I'm getting b2 and 90. So this corresponds to b2 and 90, this thing. So if I just go here and put 2 means this c3 and 100, okay? So if you just go here and run it, so as you can see here, I'm getting c3 and 100. So let's suppose that you want all the details, okay? So for that also you can do the same thing. We'll just copy this code, copy it, paste it, and instead of doing this stuff, you can just do list dot get of I dot display. That's it. So just compile and run it. So as you can see in the output, I will be having all the values. So it's having a180, b290, c300. So the only thing is that instead of hard coding or creating multiple objects, we have done by using a for loop itself, for loop and just three arrays. So this has like reduced the code considerably. Let's say that you're having 100 values, means you can just input all the 100 values here and you can just put 100 here. Just I will be less than 100, I will be less than here. That's it, you're done with the code. So by doing this way, by using a for loop for creating multiple objects, we can just reduce the code size, okay? So I just wanted to show you how you can use a for loop that can create multiple objects and hence reducing your code size. Okay, so I hope you have found this video useful. I also run many other Java videos as well as C, C++, Python, as well as 3D animation Blender. So do check out the rest of my channel, subscribe and support me. Thanks for watching.